In today's video, we are taking a pile of Himalayan salt lamps and putting them through some stress tests to see just what they can and cannot handle. Guys, ironically enough, just a few hours ago today, Veritasium released a video that debunked whether or not Himalayan salt crystal lamps were actually good for you and released enough negative ions into the atmosphere to actually boost your mood. However, we still have a bunch of salt lamps. So, we are going to be putting these through a few tests to see just what they can and cannot survive. Here's the basic idea. We have three salt lamps and we are going to see just what sort of stress tests they can handle. This is going to involve water, heat, and maybe a few other things. So as far as these lamps are concerned, it has been debunked that they can't really release that many negative ions to make a positive impact on moods or anything like that. However, there are types of crystals that have been proven to basically boost your mood because of the way they release negative ions. One of those is tourmaline. Now, that is much more expensive than Himalayan salt, which is probably one of the reasons why these are much more commercially available. That said, we just sort of want to put them to the test and see what else they can do. All right, so for our first test, well, we wanted to throw one in the forge, but it's snowing really hard outside right now, so we're gonna go ahead and stick with the indoor experiments today and then move forward from there. So first off, while I have heard that these lamps can absorb moisture from the atmosphere, I want to find out whether or not they can melt. Some people say they can't, some people say they can. Let's put it to the test. So for these videos, we don't need the base. We're just kind of taking them apart, and I am very disappointed because it's a lot easier than I wanted it to be, but it's good for our purposes. Perfect. It's a very large chunk of salt. So for one of our first stress tests here, I have heard it said that you cannot melt or dissolve one of these lamps. I don't know if that's true and I want to find out. So the first thing that we're going to do is run one of these under some water on a time lapse, see what happens. We're also going to put one in a pot of boiling water on the stove, see if it dissolves. All right, so we've got everything set up for our time lapse. Sorry about the dirty dishes, but we want to see just how long it takes to erode away one of these salt lamps. Stress test number one, can you erode a Himalayan salt lamp with water? Yes. So we were playing with glass on the table earlier, so I'm hoping this is just salt. Yeah, salt, okay. All right, stress test number two. So we have seen that you can erode away one of these salt lamps with just using tap water. So we've actually got a little setup here on the stove. So this is going to be slightly submerged in boiling water, and while I do believe that's just going to dissolve it, I'm curious to see what the steam will do. I want to see if that's actually going to help erode and dissolve the outside of it as well. We've definitely made a mess. So the salt itself seems like it's mostly been fine from the steam. Like I was expecting it to get that same glassy outside that we were getting on the one that had the water running over it and eroding it away. Instead, what we've gotten is the water itself has turned almost opaque and it's splattered salt everywhere. Like the pot is just coated in a powdery salt. And I'm very curious. I do think it's lost some of its volume here, so I'm gonna try and pick it up. I wanna know just how much of it sunk through the grating. That's kinda hot to the touch. It's not too bad, but probably want a different glove. All right, time lapse is definitely gonna show that better because we lost about half of its volume there. I was not expecting that. But it is not nearly as smooth as it was when we eroded the other one away. This is still very, very rough course, almost the same as it is on the other side. Not nearly as effective as I thought it was gonna be, especially compared to the eroding. Can you dissolve a salt lamp using steam? Yes, but it would probably take a very long time. So comparatively, running it underwater versus simply allowing the steam to do the work for you, this one's gonna survive, that one, not so much. All right, so we've tried eroding one of our salt lamps, we've tried dissolving one, and now we wanna try melting one, but to do that, we're gonna need a lot more heat. All right, guys, so we've made it up to the dome. We've already eroded one salt lamp, we've tried to dissolve another, so for our final one, we're gonna melt it. So we got this thing. This is an extra large crucible that just so happens to hold our salt lamp perfectly. So let's drop it in, see what happens. Sure, that's gonna work. It's very cold here, guys. All right, so it's been about 10 minutes and we've actually had this on time lapse, but I'm not sure if we're actually gonna get the ambient heat in our forge to be warm enough to actually melt the salt. So what we're gonna do is put the lid on now, hopefully leave it for a little while, and when we come back, it should be melted. So I just checked on this, and I think we actually managed to do this, guys. It's been about an hour and a half, which is not as long as we were expecting this to take. We have successfully melted an entire Himalayan salt lamp. Oh, wow. So I was not expecting it to have that much volume left over. Yep, Nana's on fire. I lit a stick on fire with molten salt. That's just cool. It's actually leaking out over the side. There is so much more to that than I thought there was. Well, I was gonna try and take it out and pour it into something, but with how much there is here, and with the size of that crucible, it's not really gonna be safe for me to try and lift that up and transport it. So we're gonna let it sit there and cool down, see what it looks like once it's actually solidified again. Where we can actually get our tongs around it safely, transport it, and dump it out. That's really cool. Like, I know I don't want to touch that, but I actually really want to touch that. So we left this about 30 minutes to try and let it harden. It hasn't really cooled that much. It's still radiating a ton of heat. And I'm not sure if it's solid yet. So the surface is no longer molten. Now, I don't trust that to be the case all the way through it, but we're still gonna try and get that out. That is a giant crucible just full of salt. And the surface isn't pink anymore. We're definitely gonna have to reheat this crucible to get the salt out at a later date, but it's gonna stay like that for now. So, can you erode a salt lamp away with water? Yes, you can. Can you dissolve it? Not as well, but you can still do that too. Can you melt it? Absolutely. And that was actually a lot faster than we were expecting it to be. That's pretty cool. Well, I am kind of sad that Veritasium proved that you can't actually get negative ions from heating up a salt lamp, because I think I win the award for most heated up salt lamp ever. Guys, that's not all. We've always got more for you to see. That box up at the top will take you to our latest video, and that box at the bottom is what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. Don't forget to hit this bomb so you subscribe to the club and never miss out on the fun. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.